She is withdrawn from consideration for Secretary of State after a series of Republican senators raised serious concerns for comments she made in the wake of the Benghazi attacks that took four American lives. Susan Rice acknowledging that it would be a contentious and lengthy hearing. A confirmation process would be extremely difficult. And she broke this news to Brian Williams, the anchor of NBC's Evening News.
Today, I made the decision that it was the best thing for our country, for the American people, that I not continue to be considered by the president for nomination as Secretary of State, because I didn't want to see a confirmation process that was very prolonged, very politicized, very distracting, and very disruptive, because there are so many things we need to get done as a country.
Now, Wolf, the president also released a statement saying, in part, while I deeply regret the unfair and misleading attacks on Susan Rice in recent weeks, her decision demonstrates the strength of her character and an admirable commitment to rise above the politics of the moment to put our national interests first. I should say, Wolf, that you should not expect Susan Rice to leave the administration. I don't. First, she has not resigned from her post at the UN as U.S. ambassador, but there's also talk, sources tell me, of her taking on the role of the president's national security advisor here in the West Wing, a post that does not require Senate confirmation, where she can be highly political, and it actually serves the president very well.